Hello guys, so welcome to another video on the YouTube channel La Compagnie du Rail. This will be an English video, a bit exceptional today because I want this video to be understood by people and not only French guys and French community. So I would like to introduce one of the first scenario actually available on the public beta of Train Sim World. So I want to see and I want to have you guys your point of view on the actual beta, which is actually available on Steam for those who purchased Train Simulator 2017, the Pioneer Edition. So I'm going to play one scenario only on this channel because the game is actually not really finished and I still have some issues with the game so far. So we'll try to see what we can find and what kind of scenario actually are available. There's only two scenarios. So we'll be driving one of this locomotive here, the American CSX locomotive, to make a consist, and then we'll try to drive it. But first of all, we need to join one of the locomotives, so we'll check the nearest one. As you can see, the locomotive over there is pretty far, so I'm going to walk until there. There's another one, which is a 129, so over there, and there's one here, so it's almost 27 meters from here. So actually, Train Sim World is have been available for the last 4 days, I believe, since the 7th of December on Steam for those who purchased the TS 2017 Pioneer Edition. And I believe the beta is going only for 1 week, if I'm right. I'm not quite sure about it. So let's see. Let's see first. First of all, the trains here. As you can see, one of the big news is that Train Sim World is a first person, an FPS. That's not shooting, but it's a first person train simulator. So that means you are actually, I would say, physically an engineer in the game. You can walk and you can turn your head in 360 degrees. You can walk and you can interact with the actual environment in Train Sim World. And you have some kind of at the middle of the screen of aiming targets. That means that the center of your point of view, and that turns red when you are on the track. So I'm sorry because my Train Sim World is actually set in French, but the warning you had on the screen, the warning you had is like the target is becoming red every time you reach or you approach or walk on the tracks. It's kind of a warning. It says warning on when the warning message you had says like please warning because you are actually on the track and this is a dangerous area. I never tried, to be honest. I'm not even quite sure if you can be run over by a train. I'm not sure, but then I'm not going to broadcast this on video. But anyway, so as you can see, this is actually the train, and you can really approach closely everything. You can even approach the ladder here, and when you press E, basically you can climb in. You can climb on the stairs, on the ladder. You can reach the handbrakes, and I'm not even quite sure if it's really useful, and then you push E to go down. You can even play with... one second, this was the... no... But if there was a way how to... Oh yeah. You can even remove it. As you can see, everything is actually moving. And even when the train is rolling, everything, all the parts are moving, which is actually really great. And the new Unreal Engine is pretty amazing. For some reason for me, it's a bit laggy sometimes. So I'm not going to really focus on that because it's a bit laggy. And according to the FPS, I'm only like 22 FPS. For some reason, but the game is not finished and I believe not fully optimized, so I'm not that too worried about it. So I'm going to block it once again. So we're going to approach the loco now. See the tracks, there's no train. And actually, so the game is not that For me, actually, really well optimized, but it's still a beta version, so we'll see by the beginning of new year 2018, see if the game is better. So basically, this is the logo here, the SD40 CSX. As you can see, it's a really, really great engine. It's really well done. Graphically, it's amazing. You can even check, like, the fuel on board. You can even open this and lock it again. It says climb, get on board. So we'll get on board soon. That's the locomotive here. We're on the track, so it becomes red. Everything's here. Observe ground condition before dismounting. So actually, this is what it looks like. It's really amazing. Sounds are amazing. Actually, it's really much better than the train simulator 2017 sounds, which are actually very crappy. So you can get on board and you can move and open the door directly, and then you can be on board. If you hear the sound, you can hear the engine sound, and when you close the door, it will be reduced. Well, no. Okay, no. Okay, so this is the onboard, this is the driving cab where you can sit. You can even sit here. You can sit here, you got the driving pad. Then you can sit here as well. And then, of course, we'll be sitting here. You can do actually everything, open window, close window. You can almost touch everything, even the lights. That's at the wipers, that's lights here. You can turn on leg and look at that. Look at that. Look at the lights is coming in. And it's really great because only lighting the part here with the reflections over here. It's really, really nice. Really nicely done, and you can even turn off and see. It doesn't go off straight out. It's like you see that the lights is reducing until it's getting off. It's really well done. It was really good time to change the engine, the graphic engine, because Unreal is really great. Instead of the 15 years old game engine that we were using previously. And you can even open the engine compartment. Let's see if I can show you here. Alright, control, carrier, lights. No, okay, so that's the no, right. That's what I want. Yeah, this is what I was looking for, and we're done the rest. As you can see, so I turned on the light of the driving compartment, and the light's on now. The light's on, so, and this is where you can start your engine. Actually, hopefully, when the game is actually finished and available on sale on Steam, it would be great if we can find a scenario or, you know, something different when you need to set up your engine for departure, and then you need to reach the station and couple to the rail cars or wagons depending on the choice of the scenario. That would be great. And I'm going to close the door, and I'm going to turn on then going to turn on the light compartment in that second, which was base. Okay, so once again, bear with me because everything is said in French because my computer is French, but I'm sure you won't mind about it. Okay, so basically, that's about it. That the driving, the locomotive, as you can see, like pretty, say, almost everything is clickable on this compartment. Like you can turn on the heater or just ventilation. But let's suppose it's actually cold out there, and you can hear the ventilation coming through. Okay, so I'm gonna sit here. I'm gonna have a seat here, and I'm gonna check ventilation. Let's say, yeah, let's say it's cold actually. So we want to have some heat in the driving cab. So we're going to set up everything. So I'm not going to use all the switch because I know the shortcuts. So that will be almost the same. Okay, Except this, I would say that some kind of a calculator that calculates the length of the train, but I'm not quite sure how it works actually, so I'm not going to use it, okay? It's just a communication test. How do you get that on? No. Okay. No, what did I do? How can I get that? Okay, alright, so when you use the right arrow, I didn't know that, when you use the keyboard arrow, you can set some views, okay, so actually I'm going to set on the driver too. Okay, so that's automatic brakes as the independent brake, this is the dynamic brake, which is actually the model for it, so we've got the traction handle controller, we've got the reverser, light control, so it would be medium, and you got the back lines. Okay, so normally we are almost all set, as you can see, lights are on, and front lights are on too, so it's fine. Okay, I'm not quite sure that we really need to use that one. Right. Forward. And it says go to a little parker district. Doesn't make any sense in French, but anyway. Okay, so it's actually really foggy. Turn on. You can set up the speed. So 80. 150 should be good. And we're going to release the brakes. Released. Okay. And we're going to have the first traction. Okay, so can blast some horn. Traveling 10 miles per hour. I'm going to use the hard at the moment because it's still unclear to me where to go, so I'm just gonna use the hard. The hard. We'll try to maintain 10 miles. And look at that! Look how beautiful it is. Look, everything's moving when the train's moving, and even the sound. Oh great, it's really great. And look at the tracks. When it's full of water, it's like the light reflection on the water and the wet tracks being nice. Even the tracks and the wood on it is wet, it's really, really great. So, okay, so this is where... This is where I need to go. So where I need to couple the train to here, okay. So I need to stop after this. Slow down gently. Past it, so it's fine. Alright, I'm going to stop the engine here. And technically now what I need to do is just set up the brakes. Oh, I need to sit down for that. Because you can cannot control the train. So I'm just going to set some more pressure for safety purposes. And I'm going to open the door. I'm going to close the door. I got the key, sorry. And I need to climb down the stairs. And I need now, as you can see, the tracks, so it's my engine here. The track is set to go on the right, so we need to set the track here. The junction to couple the train here. And is there any other? No, that's the only track. And then I need to couple to the wagons over there. Okay. So it's time to go back on the locomotive now. Let's close the door. Okay. Alright, so now I need to... Okay, I'm gonna watch behind and set up reverser to reverse these brakes. Reverse the train. We won't go far than 5 miles per hour, and maybe less for Kubo. So it's important to set it. Okay, I'm not going to coop at the moment, so it's alright. As the objective is complete. Okay. And now it says, get on board another locomotive. Okay, so before I do that, I'm just going to couple this. Oh, I am, sorry. Okay, I didn't know that. But I'm already coupled to it. Okay, and there is nothing here. Okay, so I'm coupled. Okay. Alright, so, stop that. Set brakes. Down jump. Okay. Stop. Lights. Set you off. Ventilation. Set you off. And so, okay, we're all good on that. And now we're being asked to change once again our new locomotive. We're actually setting it. So look at that. Okay. So you can run, basically, you can run. You run right shift and whatever your commands are, you can run. I'm crossing the tracks, I'm not even paying attention. Okay, and we're going to go on this one with the auto racks and look at that. Look the rain on it. Look how beautiful it is. It's really, really nice. Look at that. Actually, it's really great. Okay, it says this loco needs fuel. Get it to the refueling station. Okay, no worries. Let's go. Okay, I can get it. Let's see. So we need to be refueled. So let's see. Very interesting point. Let's see how it gets. Well, it seems to be full to me. 1600 gallons. Yeah. 1600 gallons. Okay, that seems to be full. Okay, maybe it's not actually reworking, but that's for the scenario itself. Okay, it's fine. Okay. Get in. Let's close the door. And let's sit and wait for instructions. So what do we do? Let's set it for departure. Alright, so we need to uncouple the train. I was sure. There it is. So what I'm gonna do right now, and there's a special comment for that. We're gonna use this yellow handle here. This yellow handle is going to disconnect everything. There we are. Okay, everything's moving and it should stop moving. See? Right, perfect. Okay. Yep, there we go. Okay, let's see. Okay, and we have to go right there. Okay. So I don't know. It's an itinerary map. That's the same. I'm not quite sure it's actually really working because for some reason I cannot see any trains on that. I don't even know where I am, or maybe no more trains are available. I don't know. So I have no idea where to go. Okay, alright, so we're going to close this. So we need to get through there. Okay, so okay, yeah, there's no other route. No, I can't. Okay, everything seems to be really... Is there any free view on here? Yeah, okay. And basically, this is where I need to go. Okay, so I need to get back in the warehouse. So that's where it is. Okay, got it. So basically what I need to do is to drive. No. I'm quite lost. I need to get on this track. So basically, is there a way to... It's going to be a pretty long way. Okay, alright. I'm gonna try to do it. Okay, so break release. Break something, please. No, well. Okay. Deactivating emergency brake, sorry. Okay. Alright. That seems to be critical. Okay, here we go. Okay. Gonna set up. Try to get some power. I believe it should get a warning message concerning the speed, but Actually, it's not really clear what the speed is. Okay, so maximum speed is 15 miles on the yard. Okay. Okay, so we can try to reduce the speed. Use the junction over here and then travel all the way back to the station. So as well, actually it's very important, like you still can, you can walk in the cab when you drive, but you cannot control the locomotive from here, but basically you can walk in. Okay, so we're approaching. So basically what I want is to start braking, not really overshoot it. Can you hear the wheels? Okay. Okay, stopping train now. And what we want now is to set up the tracks. Okay. What a weather. Okay, so the tracks need to be changed. So we'll be traveling to the left. Yeah, that's good. Okay, back, I'm gonna get away. Backlights. Okay, changing the reverser and setting up the view to see where we're going. So let's release the brakes. Brake release. Setting up some power and let's go. 15 miles is the maximum speed limit on the yard. I'm not quite sure. I'm just gonna break here because I want to make sure the tracks is actually correctly set. Okay. Now I'm not scared. And is it? Oh, shit, it was. Okay, but let's double check. Okay. Let's close that. Okay. Fit. Okay, let's go back. Thank you. what I wanted to avoid, but unfortunately. Okay, so we choose the wrong one. So we had to set. Yeah, we need to pass this again. It was wrongly set, okay. Okay. So we need to set up the junction in here, and look at that, look at the detail, it's really amazing. Okay, so, okay, the track is set. And now, we need to continue our maneuver. Okay, oops, sorry, let me sit here. And, let's reshoot. Yeah, there we go. Getting on the correct track. Hopefully. Yeah, there we go now. So as you can see, actually, this is a very straightforward scenario, as you can see. It's just like drivetrain, go there, go to point A, go to point B, fuel. It's actually a really basic scenario, but I believe we should have more complex scenario when the game is actually being fully released and terminated on Steam by beginning of year 2018. So we'll see. So actually, it's just a video just to introduce the public beta, what it looks like. Details, sounds, and what exactly, what's the potential of the brand new train scene. To be honest, I'm not a huge fan of American freight trains, because it's actually pretty slow. You would have realized that I'm actually French myself, so I would expect to have maybe at least more French routes to be created and being available for sale on Steam. Hopefully, why not? And but I prefer more passengers. I don't mind American passenger trains, which I actually like. I really like the Amtrak as well. But hopefully, I should expect to have more passengers, because I'm not really a huge fan of the American freight train, because it's really, really slow. And according to my life on the side of train scenes, it's taking a really long time to complete scenario and work on American freight train. But anyway, I mean, everyone has a choice and everyone likes different stuff. I'm actually more enjoying driving passenger trains. Okay, so let's try to make the initial depression and the brakes to stop in the correct place. Because here we are, there's the fuel pump. So, still up to just to go. There we go. There. Alright. Okay, so I'm not going to turn it off at the moment, okay, because we just need to move forward. If I was off cam, I would have done that before, so. But no problem, so this locomotive is set. So we just need this one now. We need to take care of this one. So I'm going to get on board now. Yep. Okay. And use this, let's say it's like a move on the moving table. We need to turn train 180. We need to know where is the table. Okay, so we'll see. Okay, we'll see. So sit. And it's, well, it takes me below. Okay, that's where I need to go. Okay, so I'll move forward. Backward, sorry. Water on the window, it's actually really nice to know. So it's kind of a table somewhere. I'm not quite sure where it is, but actually the map is nowhere. See, it's nowhere. As I can see, the table seems to be over there. Oh, there, that's my train here. I didn't know. Okay, so we're approaching. Okay, the table is not set. It's too bad. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. What's that? Ah, okay, I got it. So I believe I need to set up the table. So I need to get on that. Okay, that works. Okay, so now I can. Ah, right here. So you can open the door technically and you can use that. Okay, nice. Okay, yes, it's unlocked. Also, camera. But Jesus, it's actually really nice. Can I sit on that? Yeah. It's actually a real camera, it works! That's really nice, okay, but I'm not on the right correct side. This is my look over here. Okay, let's close the door. It's raining. Thank you. And listen for the noise. You can hear it. That's really nicely done, I really like it. So I want this to be set on my local. One more. One more. Perfect. Okay, so we're going to lock on the control for safety. What should I do? Should I... No, I won't need that anymore. How do you turn off? Oh, okay. Right, and I should be facing from the loco. Okay, good. Very good. That's really great. Okay. And CSS. Kermboland. MV Shop. That's really great. Okay. So I need to get in. And then where I need to go? I should get in and I believe I should leave. Okay, so I'm gonna try to get in and leave by here. By the very last one here. Okay, so let's do that. So let's get on board. Let's get on board. Now, okay. Alright, okay, so let's get in. Don't go that fast. Yeah, actually, one more. Okay, we're in. Okay. I'm gonna get down. Just very sleepy. And I'm going to oops, went to the door. Look at that, Jesus, look at that. Okay, so that's it. And basically I want to be facing off, as I say, before the last one. So I need to be there. Okay. So that normally I would say. Yeah, it's fine. It's fine. This is where I need to go, I believe. Okay. Yeah, that's true. Alright, okay. So we need to... What's wrong? Ah. Okay, and let's go. The correct one. No, one more. Cool, there we are. So as you can see, my path seems to be connected to here now, and we would be able to get through. There. Okay, there and there. Okay. Alright, okay. I will see. So I need to get all along the way. I need to drive all the long along the way here, and we'll make we'll change track then to couple on the way here. Okay, it seems to be a bit messy, but I should know what I'm actually doing. Okay, so that's locked. Unlocked, thank you. And okay, let's leave this place. Okay, let's see. That's how I understand it, so. Okay, let's see. Actually, I don't know if it's a bug or no, but this, if you look carefully, so we have the water on the window over here, but here, there is no clear water on the, my current, windscreen. Really well done, huh? believe I made a mistake. I should have turned the train on the other way. Okay, but anyway, that's fine. It was just for the purpose of the video anyway, so it's not a big deal. Okay, I'm not going to couple to the train. I'm just going to stop right here. Okay, it was just in order to show you the video and how train simulator is actually. Okay, so basically, I hope this video you would have enjoyed this video. Okay, and this is how it looks. As you can see, for me it's a bit laggy, but we'll see the final version how it is. So feel free to comment the video, feel free to share, and feel free to subscribe to this channel. I expect to have as well some French video coming in anyway, but hopefully you enjoyed it, and please share your thoughts as well concerning this public beta version. Thank you guys, and we'll see you next time through.